So I'm currently at the Toronto Eaton Centre to check out PORTL, which is a new sort of hologram technology that will beam you from one place to another. Sometimes for my job, I receive media invites to events happening in Toronto. And usually I know what they are based off the title of the email. However, Cadillac Fairview sent me an email inviting me to a holographic fashion show. My first reaction was, what is a holographic fashion show? So of course I went to check it out. So it's essentially this LED 4K panel, which is inside of a box, and it creates this illusion that somebody is standing inside of that box. But it was a really cool way to experience a fashion show, which is what the Eaton Centre brought in this technology to do.
Hey Amber, can you turn sideways so we can see that shoulder? There you go. The strength of that.
So I just finished the holographic fashion show and I have to say it was really impressive. I felt like I could reach through the box and actually touch the model. Now, while I didn't actually get to reach through the box, I was able to put myself inside of it and become a hologram, which of course I did. It was a bit of a surreal experience to see myself on screen because it didn't feel like I was looking at a television screen. It felt like I was there in that box posing. Now, I really love what the Eaton Centre is doing with the technology. They're putting it throughout the mall to help shoppers find outfits for this holiday season. Now, the fashion show worked really well with the technology, but I'm really interested to know how this is being used in other fields. So I set up an interview with someone at PORTL to learn a little more about where this technology is being used.
I've got three little children at home. I live on the west coast of the United States, and my parents, who are getting older, like many of our parents, they live in New Jersey. And I thought, wouldn't it be cool if grandma could beam into our home and we could beam into grandma's home? And so I started tinkering around with a lot of different like projection devices. And I stumbled upon a couple of really great ways to take an image from here and beam it over there.
It's on your site, and I saw that you have a mini PORTL coming out and that you have like consumer and prosumer options for people. So, which was really interesting to me because I originally thought this was for companies essentially, for like what the mall was doing with it for a fashion show. So it's interesting to see that you want it to be a consumer product. Or when are you hoping to see it sort of roll out into people's homes?
This time next year, we will be in many homes. We are shrinking down the Epic, which is the full size unit, into a bite-sized version of it that will sit on people's tabletops. So like the big one goes in the conference room and the little one goes in the living room.
Let's talk about like how the tech works though, because it actually looks like someone is standing inside of this little box. Like it did not feel like I was staring at a screen. You were able to capture the color and the depth that you otherwise can't capture with a Zoom meeting like we have right now.
So the light is evenly distributed. The projection panel is in the front. The content hits the panel, is illuminated by the light. And of course the devices themselves, the PORTLs, have depth to them. So it is an actual museum quality showcase with some depth to it. It's about 2 feet deep.
I'm interested to hear how other people have been using it and where you see the technology sort of going.
Right now, while we're in Toronto doing live stuff, we're also in Miami at Art Basel using the PORTLs as NFT displays with clothing, with artwork, with 3D models. It is the opposite of what we're doing with Cadillac Fairview. But again, it showcases just how amazing it is as a display technology, mannequin replacement, pre-recorded content played for specific audiences.
It's kind of in that like the next stage of where technology and communication is going. Like right now it's very much VR and AR, and this sort of falls into that category, which...
Well, it's R, right? It's real, right? So VR, headset, AR, download the app. This, you just walk up to it. It's already there. It's a shared experience. Hey everybody, look. Everybody come join me. Let's all look at this thing. You don't need anything to download. You don't need anything to wear. And it is it's the difference between putting on in, you know, headphones and listening to a music and going to the concert.
I'm gonna get one of these when they come out. Like, this is what I want. This is the future I wanted.
I'll make sure, I'll set one aside for you.
Amazing, perfect. Right. Now let's head back to the Eaton Center to hear from a fashion designer on how this kind of tech will impact his work.
Knowing the technology was so advanced and so cool, we really wanted to make sure that everybody understood the fact that this was happening in real time.
Can you show us the poofiness of the sleeve? There you go.
Just by this technology alone, in the world that we live in, like, this could be a huge advancement of how shows will happen from now on. Like, there'll be different ways of being experimental, using technology even further than we already have in fashion. So I think it's gonna give us a different perspective on how we can put on a show.
It'll be interesting to see how other fields adapt the technology, and it's really cool to just experience a fashion show through it. Now, I really don't think video does this technology justice. So if you want to come out and experience it for yourself, come down to the Eaton Center throughout December and check out the displays.
Job well done.
I'm Jacqueline Swan for Narcity Canada.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our Narcity channel to see more great content.